Hello everyone. Today I was going to make a teaching video, but the Holy Spirit of God spoke to me and he said no, he wanted me to send this out. And the Holy Spirit of God spoke to me and he said, look around and see the signs all around you. The Holy Spirit said the signs are before our faces. He said we're seeing that the weather is growing worse. He said a virus will sweep around the world. Watch for these signs, church. He said Christians in America will be arrested. And I said, because of the Bible? He said, no, because they are on a terrorist list. He said that, in a dream that he showed me, it was soldiers going into homes, removing weapons that the people had in their homes. Their weapons were being removed, not by our soldiers, by foreign soldiers. And the Holy Spirit said the earth is getting closer to the sun and the moon. He showed me people building homes underground and in rocks and in caves to get away from the solar flares that are coming. Church, in 2011, I made enough of warning videos that warned of the solar flares that would grow worse. And I tell you what, I saw people being scorched by this solar flares and electricity all over the world being put out because of these solar flares are going to grow worse. Something's coming from this sun, church. I've been preaching this since 2011. I've been sending out these warnings. Now, the new people might not have heard these warnings, but I know a lot of my friends that know me in 2011 know that the Holy Spirit warned of all these things that were coming. And the Holy Spirit told me, he said, to look up, that the sky will look red. He said something big is coming, and it will be the main event. He said, look up and see what falls from the sky to the earth. He said there will be a shaking in the universe, an explosion in the Milky Way, planets moving out of their places. Something is drawing these planets. Something is pulling them out of their places. I saw something the Holy Spirit showed me that looked like a wave moving through the universe that was shaking the planets. And now in the Milky Way, I saw an explosion. I saw it looked like a big explosion in the middle of it. Now, last year, God gave Preston a vision, and Preston saw a red wall blowing into Dallas, Texas. Now, we still don't know why God keeps giving him visions and dreams of Dallas, Texas, but his dreams are of Dallas. And he said that God showed him a red wall so thick he couldn't see through it. He said it was dust. It was a wall of red dust blowing into Dallas. And he said soon he was just standing there in the vision, and the dust was just all around him, and he said that he couldn't see anything because the dust was so thick. He said even in the vision he felt like he couldn't breathe because the dust was so thick. Now, he had that vision last year. I remember when he shared that vision with me. The Holy Spirit of God spoke to me and he said there will be an earthquake in Japan, Egypt, China, and Indonesia. There will be flooding in Japan and China and Indonesia. Church, you better start looking at the ocean. We're about to see some stuff in this ocean. Things are going to happen. We're going to see more animals dying in the waters. Now, church, if that ain't signs, I don't know what is. I mean, really. Does it take a Bible scholar to read the signs that are before your face? We are definitely seeing that we are in the time. We are living in the days that John saw. Remember what the Holy Spirit told me. He said, Donna, you will see things, but it will not be exactly like what John is describing, but you will see it. Because you see, if John could describe what he saw, because he's never seen it before. But we can describe it because we're seeing it. We have technology. We have knowledge. John is a man 2,000 years ago, so he's trying to describe to us with the best of his ability that he has. But we're going to see these signs, and we're seeing them now, church. And the Holy Spirit showed me those solar flares. Church, I saw them burning. Everything was burning in Arizona and Colorado and Africa. The trees, the grass was just being burned from this heat, from the solar flares. Even people were being scorched. That's why they were living underground, trying to get away from this heat. And the Holy Spirit said there'll be a volcano in Japan and in Hawaii. He said, Wormwood is coming. Be ready. Now, church, to me, this is exciting because that means we're getting ready, that this is going home time. Every time I talk to Preston, he always says to me, are your rapture ready? You got your rapture clothes on? I said, amen, I stay rapture ready. I'm ready to go. My brother, Stan's Heating, Jamie, he had a revival in a chat room. And I tell you what, the Holy Spirit of God was flowing in there. I couldn't stop crying because the Holy Spirit was so powerful and he was flowing. And Jamie put on a tape of the trumpet blowing, sounding louder and louder. Woo, glory. That was powerful right there. Hearing that sound of that mighty trumpet blowing and sounding, it seemed like it got louder and louder, and knowing that one day we'll hear that mighty trumpet sounding and we'll hear a voice that says to us, come up hither, and we will ascend up in through the door. Amen, church. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to go home, and I've been rapture ready. I'm ready to ascend. So I thank God for every one of you, and I thank God because he is calling more prayer warriors to my channel, and I thank God for that. That's a great gift to be called to be a prayer warrior, intercede in prayer. You know what a prayer warrior is? It's somebody who stays in prayer, and they don't stop praying until they feel it. They know when they've touched God. They know. That's a prayer warrior right there. They know how to pray. Amen. That's a great gift right there. And I thank God for all the prayer warriors that he's calling to me. And I thank you all for praying for me. Church, whatever we do, let's do in love, okay? Let's love one another and have compassion on one another. Let's not be hateful. You know what I'm saying, church? Let's move in the love of God, because God loves us. And not everybody is given revelation knowledge. So let's be merciful to those that are new to God, that may not have that revelation or might not understand the word of God. Let's have mercy on them. And know this, church, we were once them, amen. I didn't wake up one day having revelation knowledge. I used to stand on certain scriptures and hold on to those scriptures like death. I'd hold on to them so tight, and I'd stand on that word thinking that I was right. And I wasn't. But it took the Holy Spirit of God to give me the revelation knowledge, because I don't know anything, church. I don't know anything. I don't see the future. I don't know anything. It is the Holy Spirit of God. It is him that gives me the knowledge that allows me to see things and allows me to hear things. So I try to have compassion and love for those that do not hear, because I love you. I love you. I love all of you, new, old, beginning, just got in, been here all your lives. I love all of you, and God loves all of us. But let's have compassion on one another, and whatever we do, let's do it in love, because that's the greatest gift of all, is to love. And in doing so, you fulfill the law, because you love. God bless you, my dear precious friends, and I thank God for each and every one of you. I do. I thank God that you are willing to listen to me, to stand with me, to walk with me, and to pray for me, and to pray with me. That's a blessing. Amen. So let's go out today, church, and let's be a blessing. And remember, whatever we do, it's doing the spirit of love. Let's walk in the Spirit of God. Amen. And I tell you what, when you do that, church, you'll be blessed, because God will turn around and he'll bless you. He'll reward you. There's benefits in God. Amen, church. You wait till you tap into those benefits. You'll find out that whenever you please God and you start walking by the Spirit and not by the flesh, you'll start seeing God reward you. You'll start seeing blessings in your life. You'll start seeing your soul prosper. You'll start seeing the perfect will of God. You'll start seeing that you're standing in faith. You'll start seeing doors are open to you. God's giving you favor. God's just blessing your home and your family. Amen, church. Amen. If we're going to open any door, let's open the door of faith, the door of Jesus Christ. Let's open that door today, church, and let Jesus come into us. Amen. Let's open that door and let him in. God bless you, my dear precious friends, and I thank you so much.